All right, good morning. Good morning, everybody inside of the Death of Brick and Mortar and watching this on our social channels. Want to let you know you can always comment below and go to our links inside the comments area to learn about more of this stuff that we're teaching you guys today. Today, I'm teaching you guys a story about how a salt and pepper shaker saved this guy's business. So we import products from China. We sell products online through funnels and stores. And so when we go to China, it's always cool to stay at the Westin and listen to other people's stories of how they're selling products in retail stores, online, and other means. And I remember we went to breakfast and we're sitting there, this guy shows up, and my question was always, you know, how many containers are you importing into the United States or into your country? And this guy happened to be from Australia. And he goes, oh man, we import 80 to 100 containers a year. I was like, wow, that's incredible. I said, ask him what he did. And he was actually the owner, actually enough. If you're from Australia, maybe you know this. But he was the owner. I don't know if it was the Big W, the Woolworth, or if it was Kohl's. It was one or the other. I'm pretty sure it was Kohl's. But we'll go with that. So I asked him. I said, man, that's quite a bit of product that you're pushing. You know, you got vacuums. You got lawn care. You got all the different departments, such as like a Walmart. So the equivalent of a Walmart in the United States. And I was curious. I was like, hey, what is the top product that you sell, if you don't mind me asking? And he goes, you know, believe it or not, it's salt and pepper shakers. I said, salt and pepper shakers is the number one selling product. I was like, okay. And he goes, what's crazy is I don't make any money on them. I'm like, you don't make any money on them. I was like, well, so it's the number one selling, of course, is, so you're selling them for cheap. He goes, I sell it actually for less than what I buy it for. And I go, okay, tell me more. Like, explain this to me. Why is that working for you? And he goes, we use them as what we call as loss leaders. And what we do is we have a catalog that goes out every month, and I always put items like trinkets on the front cover that I can get from China for reasonably a good amount. And I'll put them on there for less than what I pay for them. So if I'm even paying them for like $1 for a salt and pepper shaker, I'll sell them for 50 cents or I'll sell them for 25 cents. And I'll put them on the front cover and I'll say, hey, come into our store and grab these salt and pepper shakers for 25 cents today only. So he's creating urgency for it. Limited supply, low stock, right? So again, urgency, fear-based. And he goes, these people come in, they buy this, but what they do is I put these salt and pepper shakers all the way at the back of the store. And so they got to walk through my entire store to go and find these salt and pepper shakers. And meanwhile, they're filling up their carts. And so when I'm losing 25 to you know, a dollar on that product, I'm making $25 on my average cart value. So every person that comes to our store, the average cart is about 25 bucks. And so I know the more people that I can get through that front door, the more carts that I'm going to have going outside that door. So that's how it became my number one seller inside my store, because everybody needs a salt and pepper shaker. It's a global offer, right? It's a public offer. And that's what I love. I love public offers. I love global offers that works for pretty much anybody that has a beating heart or within a realm of space of people, because you just have so much exposure to that audience. And so with these salt and pepper shakers, imports them from China by the container load, puts them in the back shelves, puts them on the front of his catalog, and sells them. And that's the same thing that we do, right? But we just do it online, and we do loss leaders or break-even funnels. And that's the same thing that you guys should be doing. Like, how do I get as many people in the door as possible to see my website, to see my brand, to see what we are selling through our storefront and through our funnels? How do I get those people in here? Now, what it usually comes down to is three things, right? Is the three things of building a business. The first one is this, and maybe you guys already know this. The first one is gaining leads and customers. You need leads and customers in order to fill in the next two. But what do you do? How do you get people to be incentivized? You know, if you're selling a bed, like if you're doing bed commercials, a bed's $1,000, $2,000, or maybe furniture. We just actually went to the furniture store. It was like $2,000 or five. I think we spent $5,000 on a sofa, like ridiculous. But $5,000, like, not everybody's gonna go spend $5,000 today. But what if they were selling lamps for $25, right? And get a ton of people in their store for these lamps. Well, lamps, as you guys know, go for 100, 150 bucks a lamp, right? But if they're selling for $25 special deal down at this furniture store, people are gonna go in there, see all the other furniture that these people are selling, and be like, oh man, we, you know what, we could replace our couch, or we could get a lazy chair, or we could get a movie room theater kind of equipment, or maybe we could get a pool table or a shuffleboard. Right? But they weren't thinking that prior to going into that store. They went into that store with the incentive to go and grab a lamp for $25. So when you're building your funnels, you want to look at what kind of products can I put in front of my audience, in front of my niche, that gets them to say, yes, I want to put my name and information. I want to know and understand this company more, because if they got deals like this, then what other deals do they have? You know, we get so involved in our business that we think everybody knows about it, but realistically, no one knows about it. And so it's up to you to advertise, 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 and get traffic, traffic, traffic as much as you can, right? Like affiliate traffic, Facebook traffic, Instagram, social traffic, influencer traffic, email, direct mail, radio, television, all of it, right? Because the more places you are, the more omnipresent you are, the more this is going to work in your favor. So what do we do? That's why these are so important. And it was a great epiphany for me. It's like, man, salt and pepper shakers. It's so easy, so simple. And that's why inside the perfect product, we're doing stickers. Because stickers are so simple to create, they're very inexpensive, and they have a crazy amount of big margin, 13,200% margin markup. You can buy a sticker for 4 cents, sell it for $6.95, make great margins, pay for Facebook traffic, and check off number one, which is gaining leads and customers. Because these leads and customers are gonna create the next one, which is your upsells, right? You can't sell, this is so funny, you can't sell any upsells unless you have customers and leads. You have to have a customer come through your funnel in order to sell those upsells, right? A lot of people look at their upsell and like, oh, it's not converting, it's not working. You don't have any traffic on the front in order for the upsell to even convert. There's no one seeing it. It's not broken. Same thing with your order form. A lot of people think their order form's broke because no one's buying. Well, how many people saw it? 10. Well, where they get stuck at? Sales page. Well, it's not, your order form is not broke. Your sales page is broke. See, all these things flow in the right order. And then number three, what do you guys think that is? LTV, lifetime value of the client. The lifetime value of the client, that's bringing them back into your funnels. That's doing, you know, your follow-up. That's bringing them back into your store. That's bringing them back into and buying from your brand. That's coming and bringing them back into recurring offers, right? Continuity, passive income. But you can't get any of this unless you have leads and customers coming through your funnel. And there has to be a reason, my friends. There has to be a reason. I know you can think that your product is the best product on the world, and it is so awesome, right? And that might be true, and only so many people are gonna buy it though. So we have to incentivize other people to come through your funnel, to learn about your brand, to learn about your continuity passive income places, to learn about your upsells, to learn about your Shopify stores and your backend funnels. We have to get them to say, man, I'm gonna take my time, stop scrolling on my phone, pull out my wallet, my credit card, and pay this person for this product. See, there's so much inertia, there's so much competition right now of gaining that person's eyeballs that we have to incentivize them in order to come in. And for us, we're doing it through stickers. And you guys can, you know, hit up talktotrey.com if you wanna learn more about that, how we're selling hundreds of thousands of stickers through all of our clients and how they're doing it too. Or you can try it the hard way, you know, figure out how this works. How do I find a product, right? Where do I even start? How do I know it's a winning product? How do I know it's gonna break even on the front end? How do I make sure that I'm not losing money like the salt and pepper shaker guy? How do I know that my average cart value is gonna be big enough? There's a lot of pain points that really kind of go into a lost leader funnel. You can figure that all out, or you can just grab perfect product training and we show you exactly how to do it, right? We show you the carts, we show you the recurring, we show you the passive income behind it, we show you the funnels, we show you the follow-up emails that go into place and all the things that happen in order for that to work. But either way, you wanna have this. You wanna have some sort of lead generation, customer generation flowing into your business in order for you to prosper. Going back to the guy at, what was it, Kohl's? Going back to Kohl's, the guy does the same thing. He does the same system in retail. He uses salt and pepper shakers. That's why it's so important to use salt or a front-end loss leader or break-even funnel to bring customers in, to build your database, to build your leads, so you can go and sell them more things, so you can create a profit. And then at the end of the day, what's the big one? You've built a brand, you've built a customer database, right? You have front-end offers that are building this stuff, and then you sell. You can sell that brand for 10x EBITDA. If you're making $1 million a year, let's say, well, you could probably get 10 million out of it. It's crazy. But it starts here. This is the core. This is the foundation of building a business. This is where it all starts, my friends. This is the basics. If you follow these right here, these basics, well, you'll start making money online. It's as easy as that. My friends, videos like these, we keep putting them up Tuesday, every Tuesday at 8:30 a.m. Central Standard Time. That is 9:30 Eastern for you guys. Pacific, way over there on the coast. What time is that for you? Is it 9, 8, 7? No, it's 6:30 in the morning, so we're bringing our coffees in the Pacific, okay? No big deal. But for everybody, we come on here, we give you guys information. These are great little tidbits to take home. Implement this week, and then come back and show back up for our calls at 8:30 a.m. Central Standard Time to get more nuggets like this, to keep implementing this business. And if you're looking to get better at it, to add more funnels, to add more front end, to have leads and generations, I encourage you to check out talktotrey.com. Go there. I think we do a 15-minute call with you, learn about your business, see what you're doing, see if it's a good fit. All right, we'll see you guys next week. Appreciate you being on here. Bye-bye.